So in this talk, I will present some recent and much older results about the entropy of CR smooth dynamical systems. And I will mostly focus on the case of the interval. So, but in general, I will so consider the space or CR continuous map on the compact smooth Riemannian manifold M and with the usual CR topology. So here R will be larger than 1, maybe infinite, but not necessarily an integer. So let me recall classical notation. So for F in this space, I will denote the topological entropy by H top of F. Now, if I have F invariant measures, I will denote the Kolmogorov-Sinai entropy of this measure as this. And finally, let me denote by max of F the set of invariant measures which maximize the measure theoretical entropy. That is H of mu F is equal to the supremum of the measure theoretical entropy function. And I will also consider the space M max erg, where here I consider ergodic measures. So here it is well known by classical variational principle that this supremum is equal to the topological entropy of F. So the property I will consider in this talk are the following. So first, the finiteness and non-emptiness of the set max erg of F. So maybe a first remark is that when you have a maximal measures, I mean a measure of maximum entropy, almost all its ergodic components are also of maximal entropy. So the second property I will investigate is the upper semi-continuity of either the topological entropy as a function of the dynamical systems. So upper semi-continuity means that the limb soup of the topological entropy of G when G is going to F is less than the topological entropy of F. But I will also be interested in the upper semi-continuity of the measure theoretical entropy function for a fixed dynamical systems. So, and the third property I will consider is the following. So I will be interested in the equidistribution of periodic points along maximal measures. So I will explain later precisely what I mean here. So to prove such properties, usually you have two ways. So either your dynamical system satisfies strong local dynamical properties. For example, it is well known that an expansive dynamical systems, for an expansive dynamical system, the measured theoretical entropy is upper semi-continuous, and thus admit a measure of maximal entropy as an upper semi-continuous function on a compact metric space always attains its supremum. So, but as we will see, we can define a weaker notion of expansivity which still ensures the upper semi-continuity of the entropy. Okay, so this first approach is very good, but in our context, it will be satisfied only for C infinity maps. So for CR maps with R finite, we need something else. So, and the second method is to construct a good Markov representation. Of your systems, and then apply Jurvich theory, which gives some criteria for the existence and finiteness of maximal measures for the Markov shift associated to an oriented graph. So, but here, in general, it's very difficult to construct a good Markov representation of your systems. Okay, but for CR interval maps, we have such representation. So, in the first part of my talk, I will recall some applications of Yamdin's theory in this context. So, and I will revisit a little the exposition. So let me introduce some notation here. So I consider CR dynamical system here on a compact manifold on any dimension. So let me introduce this quantity, R of t, which be the exponential growth of the derivative. Okay, and let me also define the infinite dynamical balls at some point x in M and with scale epsilon, which is just the set of points whose orbits stay epsilon close to the orbit of x. So being forward expansive means that there exists epsilon, so that for all x, this dynamical balls is reduced to the point x. Here, we will define a weaker notion of expansivity. So for that, I will define a new quantity, which I will call tail robust entropy. Maybe robust entropy is better. So I will look at first the topological entropy. Okay, here I will denote T here for the dynamical system. So I consider the topological entropy of the Bowen balls of some for some dynamical system S. So this, Then I take the supremum over X in M and over S in some neighborhood U of F for the CR topology. And then I take finally the infinimum over all scales, epsilon, and over all neighborhood, CR neighborhood of F. So I will denote this quantity like this. Okay, and so the main application. Yes, it is a topological entropy, but for the dynamic for S.
But S is restricted to this set.
Yes. S is a dynamical system in the CR neighborhood U of F. Of T, sorry. Oh, yeah, maybe it's better. It's T here. Sorry. Yes. Okay, so the main application of Yamdin's theory is the following statement. Which says that if T is CR dynamical systems, then the robust tail entropy is less than the dimension of M times the growth, exponential growth of the divided, divided by R. So this was proved essentially by Busy, but Yamdin first proved such a statement not for this local entropy, but for the local volume growth. And then Busy, using the same strategy of Yamdin, proved this inequality. Okay, so now let me just state quite general lemma. And see how, together with this theorem, you get a pure semi-continuity of the entropy. So the lemma is the following. So I just say that the Lim soup, when nu g goes to nu f, so here nu is a g invariant measures, and mu is the F invariant measures. Mu is going to mu in the weak star topology, and G is going to F here in the CR topology. So I just say that, okay, the default of upper semi-continuity of the measure, of the entropy is seen as a function of the measure and the map itself, is less than the robust tail entropy. Lim soup, sorry.
Thank you. The definition of R of T, TTN depends on the point X. So,
yeah, is the supremum? Yes, it is the supremum norm of. Thank you. So, together with this theorem, you get the following so well known corollary. So, the first one, which is due to Neuhaus, whose proof do not follow this line, but okay, this is so he proves that for C infinity map, the measure theoretical entropy is upper semi-continuous.
so let me better.
And thus, any infinity dynamical system admits maximal measures. And previously, Yomdin proved that the topological entropy is semi-continuous. So there is another easy consequence of this lemma, which seems new to my knowledge, is the following. Okay, so in the case I consider C infinity interval maps or C infinity surface diffeomorphism, we have that the topological entropy is continuous. So upper semi-continuity follows from Yomdin's theorem, but the lower semi-continuity was also established for C0 interval maps by Mezovich and for C1 plus alpha surface diffeomorphism by Katok. As in this case, entropy is characterized by horseshoes, which persist under perturbation. So in this case, these two cases where the topological entropy is continuous, so this was known, but then the set of maximal measures moves in an upper semi-continuous way. So this is a compact set, as the measure theoretical entropy of a C-infinity map is upper semi-continuous. And so I just said that this is upper semi-continuous when here you consider the Hausdorff topology for compact sets. So in easy terms, it just says that if you consider mu n, a measure of maximal entropy of Tn, and Tn is going to T in the C-infinity topology, then any weak limit of mu n is also a measure of maximal entropy of T. So it's kind of... Okay, so... So now I will now only consider the interval. And I will investigate the problem of existence and finiteness of ergodic maximal measures. So Yomdin theory just says that for C infinity interval maps, you have maximal measures, but it says nothing about CR interval maps with finite R. And in any case, it says something about the finiteness. So the theorem is the following. There is many people participate. So you consider a CR interval maps. So here I recall that R is always larger than one. So that the topological entropy is larger than R of F divided by R. So then, there is finitely many ergodic maximal measures and a non-zero number. There exists also maximal measures. Okay, so this statement was proved by Busy for C infinity interval maps. And then for CR interval maps with Ruette, he proved this statement, but with a factor two. So I just delete the factor two, so my contribution is very weak in this statement. But now we have something sharp. By which I mean, here we know examples of CR interval maps with topological entropy equal to these terms, and so that the map do not have any maximal measures. And similarly, you have CR interval maps just as the topological entropy is arbitrarily close to these terms and with infinitely many maximal measures. So this shows that the lower bound here is sharp with respect to the problem of finiteness and existence of maximal ergodic measures. So to prove this, we use the second approach. So, I mean, we build a good Markov representation of your system, and then we apply Gurvitch theory. So let me explain in more details this step. So essentially here, this lemma is due to Busy. It proves that there exists a graph, an oriented graph, which is known now as the Busy-Hofbauer diagram. It is, in fact, an adaptation of Hofbauer diagram for piecewise monotone interval maps. So, and a map. So let me denote the Markov shift. It's associated in Markov shift like this. That is the set of sequences so that two elements of the sequence are. Bigger. So there exists a graph and a semi-conjugacy, measurable semi-conjugacy from the Markov shift to with the So let me maybe you here. So there is D and a semi-conjugacy P from the Markov shift with the dynamic of the interval, which induce so bijection so between measures, so a bijection between measures of maximal entropy. Oh, it's not exactly. Induce a bijection which preserves, preserving the entropy. Between measures with positive entropy. So to prove that F has non-zero maximal measures or finitely many maximal measures, you only need to do this for the Markov shift associated to this graph. So then we can apply the following result of Djurovic, which says that if the Markov shift associated to an oriented graph has no or infinitely many maximal measure, ergodic maximal measures, then there exist ergodic measures on the Markov shift such that so the limit of the entropy of nu n is equal to the supremum of the entropy function of the Markov shift. And nu n goes to infinity in the graph, which means that for all finite set of vertices, we have the measure with respect to nu n of the element of my Markov shift such that alpha 0 belongs to F goes to 0 when n goes to infinity. So then to prove this theorem, we only need to control the entropy of measures which goes to infinity in the graph. So and we can do this, and I will not explain the proof as I didn't define precisely the graph, but can prove that limit of h of nu n is less than the log of the supremum norm of the derivative divided by r when nu n goes to infinity in the graph. So this is the main steps of the proof and how we can apply Djurovic theories to prove the existence and finiteness of maximal measures. Okay, so now I will consider the problem of upper semi-continuity of the topological entropy in this context. So we have the following theorem. So let F be in CR internal maps. Then the Lim soup. Okay, so here just the limit. The topological entropy of G when G is going to F is equal to the topological entropy of F. And here it's false like this. I need an hypothesis. Okay, so say when the topological entropy of F is larger than the symbol here, R of F divided by R. So the fact that the topology, the lower semi-continuous property, as I said before, follows from a result of Mizrovich. Here, we only need to prove the upper semi-continuity of the topological entropy. And same remark here, the lower bound is sharp. And we may find CR interval maps with topological entropy strictly less than R of F divided by R, which is not the point of continuity of the topological entropy. So I will not have time to give very much detail to the proof, but the idea is to consider some map Fn going to F in the CR topology, and to consider the graph, the Busy-Hofbauer diagram of Fn and the Busy-Hofbauer diagram of F. And we can see that in some sense, this sequence of graph is converging to the graph given by F. And then we can apply a theorem, which is a pure abstract theorem for graph, I mean, which really looks like this one, and conclude in the same way that in some sense, you have measures which goes to the infinity, and now it's not in a one graph, but in this sequence of graph. And so that the entropy is less than this quantity, and the entropy of this sequence nu n is exactly the limit of the topological entropy of Fn. Okay, so I just want to finish this talk with problem of equidistributions. Of periodic points for interval maps. So let me introduce some notations. So let me denote by Pn the set of n periodic points of the considered dynamical systems. So for smooth maps, I will denote by Pn delta the set. Okay, I consider smooth C1 for CR interval maps here. So n periodic points with Lyapunov exponent larger than delta, so delta is positive. And finally, let me introduce again another quantity. Consider the set of periodic points. So this will be a subset of this one. But these periodic points will live in a uniformly expanding set. So more precisely, you will have the growth of the derivative for any k and for any I from 0 to n minus 1. Sorry, x is p. Thank you. And so L is a positive integer. So the classical result for the equidistribution of periodic point along maximal measures is due to Bowen. Says that if T is expansive and has the specification property, then, okay, so maybe I should introduce some of the notation. So, mu n, the measure given by the periodic point, goes to the unique maximal measures. So this allows to prove the equidistribution of periodic points along maximal measures for uniformly hyperbolic dynamical systems. And now I just want to state some results for non-uniformly hyperbolic case, so for interval maps. So there is a result of Gelfert and Wolf. Which says that if F is a C1 plus alpha interval maps, so it is true in a larger setting, but let me formulate it like this. Then a weak limit, so of mu n delta, so there, no, it's not precisely, I don't want to write it like this, sorry. So then there exists a sequence NL going to infinity, so that U N L delta L, which is the measure given by periodic points in this set. So just replace the definition here, the set of periodic points by the periodic points in P N delta N. So this goes to, so they assume also that there is a unique maximal measures. Then it goes to this unique maximal measures, so for a subsequence. So, but in fact, it's the proof we of this theorem you reduce to the hyperbolic case. As I said, all these periodic points give some uniformly hyperbolic set. Okay, so it's not really non-uniformly hyperbolic. So I will prove the following theorem. So I hope to have, so let F then any weak limit of mu m delta. So here, sorry, delta should be, it's for any delta less than the topological entropy. So then any weak limit of mu n delta, so here I consider the set P n delta, is measure of maximal entropy. So, and the idea of the proof is quite similar from the upper semi-continuity of the entropy function for C-infinity maps from Yamdin bounds of the robust tail entropy. Here, the main point here is to prove that we have a local, a small local periodic growth of periodic points for C-infinity maps. So precisely, so let me define another quantity, P delta star of T. So here I do not look at the topological entropy of Bowen balls, but I look at the exponential growth of periodic points with exponent larger than delta in a Bowen ball. So look at the lim sup 1 over n. So log so this is the finite Bowen ball. So here I take the lim sup in n. So before to take the lim sup, I need to take the supremum over x. And I take again the infimum over epsilon positive. So this is a kind of analog of the tail entropy, but for the problem of growth of periodic points. So the key lemma in the proof of this theorem is the following estimate of this local quantity. Then, so this P delta star of T, of F, sorry, is less than the log of the supremum number of the derivative minus delta divided by r minus 1. Okay. So let me maybe again explain in a few minutes how you prove this theorem from this one. So here I define the local quantity for the exponential growth of periodic points, but I may consider the global growth, by which I mean the, here I will consider the lim inf. It is the log of the supremum norm of the derivative minus delta divided by r minus 1. So if I consider the lim inf of the growth, exponential growth of periodic points with Lyapunov exponent larger than delta, then we have the following lemma, which is not difficult, which says that any weak limit of mu n delta, so any weak limit mu of mu n delta satisfies h of mu f is larger than the growth of periodic points minus the local growth. Okay, and now it's done because for for C1 plus alpha maps, we know it's an adaptation of Katok's theorem to endomorphism, that P delta of F is always larger than the topological entropy. And by this previous estimate here, you have that the local volume growth is zero for C infinity maps. So you get that any weak limit of the atomic measure given by the periodic points equidistribute along maximal measures. So thank you.